I'm in the beer aisle in Tesco's in the Isle of Man, where all the bottled beers is still the same as they were 5 years ago. And the craft beers over here, they're all IPAs or pale ales. So it's all very, very, very samey. But the worst I've seen so far, apart from Doombar, is this Ashfield's British Bitter. And it's 2.1%, and you get four cans for £1.05. Bloody awful, isn't it? Fortunately, in Douglas, we've got a bottle shop, the only one on the island, and it's called Bottle Monkey Beer Shop. So I think that's where should we head now, eh? Let's get ourselves to the Bottle Monkey. See you in a minute. Hi everyone, here we are in the Bottle Monkey Beer Shop. It's probably the only one on the island because supermarkets take over now. We haven't got any off licenses anymore, but here you've got a full range of beers from all over the world. And this is the owner, Chris.
All right.
So Chris, when did you start all this and why?
Bottle Monkey started about 4 years ago, originally just doing pop-up beer tastings and stuff. Then after a couple of years, I was walking past this place that used to be a fancy dress shop, and just thought it was an ideal sort of place, so we spoke to the landlord and we took it on and opened up the bottle shop.
Oh, brilliant. So I've noticed from all over these, aren't they? From Europe, Asia, America. So do you have any problems being on an island? Do you have any problems sourcing it?
It's not so much sourcing it, it's getting it here.
Right.
So we work with various haulage firms to help us get stuff to the island, but getting hold of it's not such a big problem. It's literally getting it from the UK to the island, man.
Yeah, really good. And a good thing I noticed when I came in the other Friday, all young people playing dominoes. That was great.
Yeah, we've got a selection of games and stuff. So there's all kinds from Cards Against Humanity, dominoes, Jenga, all that sort of stuff. Just invite people to come in.
It's like going back to old school, isn't it? It's great stuff.
Yeah, and if you go out in the back room, we've got video games as well.
Yeah. All right, now that's good stuff. Right, so I've got four samples of beers here because we have got six samples you got on draft. So I've got four here, and it's got me notes. So this one, what's this one called, Chris?
That one's called Atlantean from White Hag in Ireland.
Right, 5.4. Thought that was going to be really hoppy, but it's nice, nicely balanced.
No, it's got a nice balance to it. New England IPA, quite. A lot of grapefruit going on.
Is it a New England IPA? Is it right? Yeah. I like that. Oh. So the next one we've got is from Tiny Rebel, which have gone quite crafty nowadays, haven't they? And this is called Pool Party at 5.3%.
Yeah, so that's a passion fruit wheat beer.
Right.
Wheat IPA.
Right, okay. It's got a nice nose on it. It smells passion fruit actually. That's got a bit more meatiness about it. That's I like that. I think number two so far, Pool Party.
Yeah, so it's really fruit forward that.
Yeah, yeah. So number three, what's this one, Chris?
This is from Heist Bruco in Sheffield, and it's called You Can't Find a Good Carb Boot These Days.
What's it called?
You Can't Find a Good Carb Boot These Days.
Blimey, that's a mouthful, isn't it? Blimey, let's try
that's
this one.
That's a rye IPA.
Now that's more the colour I'm used to. Not as much nose as on this as them two. Bit of smokiness there. It's quite deep that.
Yeah,
I like
so you
that
get
one.
That, yeah. A bit of spice from the rye as well.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I like that. Right, and the last one is from Somerset.
Yeah, Wild Beer Co. Under the Sun. So it's another light sort of session IPA, very fruity.
What's the strength of this, Chris?
That one's about 4.7.
4.7, right. So this is from Somerset. That has a pine taste to it, straight away.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, I quite like the middle two, I think. Tiny Rebel and the, what's that say? Heist. Heist, yeah. Yeah, quite like them too, but all four of them. Oh, nice, aren't they? Yes. So, how often do you go through your bestseller like?
Basically, we don't keep anything on draft all the time.
No. Nope.
Once a keg's gone, that's it.
Yeah.
Got something else in. I think the only beers we've ever repeated have been Polano, which we had for House Lager for a little while, and Soup from Garage Beer Co. we've had a couple of times, but other than that, we've never repeated a beer yet.
Oh, that's good, not repeating, yeah. So what's your favourite type of beer?
As you can probably guess, I drink pretty much any style,
yeah.
But
great
most
stuff,
of the time these days it's a nice German lager or something in that style,
yeah.
So once you've tried everything you work your way back around to
that. Oh, beer. Right, yeah, yeah, yes, right, so... Me and Chris, the other day, went to the wildlife park, Somebody's trying to phone me to get off. Went to the wildlife park, which is north of the island, and we have monkeys up there because this is called Bottle Monkey. And there's a monkey in the tree, and it had a tin opener in one hand and a banana in the other. And I said, you don't need a tin opener to peel a banana. And the monkey said, it's not for the banana, it's for the custard. There you go. Blimey, strange, that, isn't it? And later on, two of the monkeys were in the bath, and one of them went, and the other monkey said, well, put some more cold in then. Blimey, it's crackers up there. But we had a good day out, didn't we, Chris?
Always.
So, always, yes. So, this is Bottle Monkey. If you don't know where it is, it's down the road from the Prospect and just behind a pub called the Thirsty Pigeon, which we reviewed a couple of weeks ago. So, great stuff in here. Good range of beers. You're very welcome. You can sit and have a drink. I tend to have a beer while I'm choosing my ales. That's the best way of doing it, isn't it? So, what do you think, Chris? Good stuff.
All good. Thank
you
very much.
You're welcome. See you, folks. See Cheers ya. Now. So, no matter how old you are, you never stop learning, do you? And coming from a traditional beer background, I've learned more about craft beer today from Chris and the Bottle Monkey Beer Shop. So, great stuff. Thanks for that little tasting session. Really enjoyed it. So, on the way out, I grabbed some dark beers. And when I say grabbed, I bought them, like, you know. But I bought this one, Dark Star Imperial Oatmeal Stout, 8% from the Fremont Brewery in Seattle. Yes, USA. So, and it's quite a meaty beer, this. Oh, malty, chocolatey, roasty, massive long finish. Everything you want in a stout, really good. Big nose on it, tanned head, black as ace of spades. Oh, really like that. Only downside, the cans are too small. These 330ml cans, not good for me. I drink pints, don't I? I drink these pints. So anyway, next week, back in my comfort zone, in a Manx pub, very historic pub, south of the island, back on the cask, and looking forward to that. So thanks for watching. Catch you later. Keep subscribing. If you don't, keep slurping. And thanks very much, everybody. Cheers. Bye-bye.